talk about the fight itself.
Yeah.
Kambosos is tall. He's a good boxer. He's a good mover. What is it, 19-0, 10 knockouts?
Yep.
What do you need to do to slow him down? What do you need to do to get the victory without giving away your whole game plan, obviously?
I don't have a game plan. Every time I go in there, I don't, you know, it's all about
freestyle.
Adjusting. It's all about adjusting in there, you know. The moment they have a game plan, that's the moment you lose. You know, there's no game plan for us. You know, my whole thing is, you know, we work on the things that we need to work on, of course. Certain tactics and certain things that a fighter may be, you know, very comfortable at doing or, you know, love to throw. And, you know, we just adjust to those things. Some minor adjustments, but overall, we don't have a game plan. My whole thing is about just adapting. That's my game plan.
Do you want to go for the knockout? Do you want to go for the decision? Do you
yes.
just...
The whole thing is not going for the knockout. The knockout will come. You know, the whole thing is like this. It's all about staying focused. You know, when you look for the knockout, you end up getting knocked out, you know, or you don't get it. So it's all about just placing my shots, being smart, staying composed, and seeing those openings that I will see when I face Kambosos on June 19th.
Obviously, you're not putting anything ahead of Kambosos, but in the past, you said you're thinking of moving up to 140. Gervonta Davis, 135, 130 champ, going to fight Mario Barrios, the champ at 140. Yes. How do you see the fight unfolding?
Honestly, you know, he's jumping up from 130 to 140, so he's going up two weight classes, you know, and Mario Barrios is not a pushover, so I think that it's going to be a good fight for him. You know, it's going to be a good fight, and we get to see what he's all about, what he's able to do at the bigger weight class. You know, I don't think that he may have the size, but at the end of it all, he probably has the power for it. So,
another fight in your zip code is Devin Haney-Linares. Now, I talked to Linares' team. They told me that he's been knocking out cold every sparring partner. So what do you think about the fight?
Sparring. You know what I mean? It's different when it's when you're under the lights, under those big bright lights, you know? So, hey, we'll get to see, you know, we all get to see what Leonardo's is all about and Devin Haney on May 29th.
That's true. An interesting fight, too. I know you and Tyson Fury are very close. He was announced the Joshua fight 24 hours later. He's now fighting Wilder right here in Vegas. Break down that fight, Wilder Fury. Three.
Ain't boxing crazy, I swear. Boxing is so unpredictable. It's unorthodox. And that's the thing, you know, that's what it is about the sport, man. Shit happens, you know, and just to see that go down, man, I was really looking forward to AJ and Tyson Fury to see an undisputed heavyweight world champion. That's what the fans really want. You know what I mean? But hey, Wilder and his team and obviously Al Haymon and everything, they know what they're doing, and they were able to get the fight happen and made. Obviously we've seen that Malik Scott is training Wilder and everything, so that's good for him, man.
Shout out to Malik, he's a good dude, man.
Shout out to Malik, man, and shout out to Deontay Wilder. They're doing their thing, they're staying focused and everything. So, you know, we'll see what happens. You know, I think, you know, sometimes they got to take a loss, but it's not a loss. It's a learning experience, and maybe he might learn something from this.